Capgemini, one of the world's foremost providers of consulting, technology, and outsourcing services, reports results for the first half of 2015. Paul Hermelin, welcome.
Hello.
You are the CEO of Capgemini. What are some of your takeaways from your first half results? Has your optimism of 6 months ago been reflected today in these first half results?
I think H1 shows a good set of very positive figures and achievements. First, on top line, we are growing in line with our expectation and guidance. We are even raising a little bit the guidance. We experienced some good growth. Notably, I want to point at North America, where we grow again more than double digit, 12%. So that's quite remarkable. And in spite of some anticipated revenue, we also see a very strong growth in emerging market, Latin America and Asia Pacific, 15%. Okay, Europe is a little less active, but everybody knows that. So I think that's pretty good. But what is, my view, a big step in the group history is 80 basis points of progression of our operating margin. That gets us now in line for my 10% ambition. Our guidance is getting close. And I think that's very encouraging to show that the group status is one of the leader of the profession. And I think the group will rapidly be a double-digit margin company. And that's quite rewarding.
You've just completed the $4 billion acquisition of a US IT firm, IGATE. How are you facing up to the integration challenge?
IGATE is a remarkable company. That explains why we just chose to spend $4 billion. So what do we get with IGATE? We get a strong reinforcement of our footprint in North America. As we just saw, we are growing well in the US, but we are something like 17 before that acquisition. With IGATE, we moved to number 12, and I want us to join the top 10 organically. So we must complete that. So it's a story that where revenue synergies are more important than cost synergies because we are very complementary, nearly no client overlap. So it's about creating synergies, it's about people collaborating, it's about selling Capgemini offer into the IGATE customer base and vice versa. So that's based on collaboration. That's why we have just launched a big work stream, set of work stream to focus on the different sides of collaboration. Very exciting. I just shared a meeting with 80 people from both origin. Everybody was very positive, very excited. The absolute mandate is that we must be ready to operate as one company as of January, which means that we will have to prepare the budget as one company. So the design, the detailed design of the integration will be available by late September so that we work. And on January 16, one new Capgemini company enriched with IGATE talents.
What is your outlook for your emerging markets business, in particular in Brazil, where you have some major contracts?
So, frankly, we say Asia Pacific will remain a growth territory, and I hear all some anxiety about China. We're not that exposed to China, so the rest of Asia will fuel growth. In Latin America, frankly, the Brazil turmoil will hit us. I would not think we will shrink. I would just say I don't expect much growth. The relationship with Caixa, that is our main client and a shareholder, is excellent. So I think we have some assets to resist the turmoil, but it's a shaky picture and a shaky industry for a while.
What is your view on your European business, in particular the redesign contract in the UK?
So the first point, in the UK, contrary to the first quarter, we are growing again. If you neutralize that huge contract, and I remind you that what we lost in that contract are what we call technically pass-through revenue. So we subcontracted a lot of service to large company like Fujitsu with no margin, no benefit. Our client asked to directly contract with them, so no pain for the company, but that hits the top line. So it's even beneficiary for the margin. So no worry there. Beside that, in Europe, let's say we have some solid rebound in Nordic, Germany, even Southern Europe, Italy, Spain, and we have a soft region between Benelux and France. Some good news, some less good news, so just say we are pretty flattish in that part, and I don't see that change much in the rest of the year.
How are you using digital to further grow your business in industrialization and in innovation?
This year, the fashion is digital. Last year, it was big data, a year before, cloud. So we call that innovative skill. We regroup that under SMAC, which stood and stands today for social, mobility, analytics, cloud. And I think that's growing very fast. The growth in the second quarter is 25%. These innovative services represent now more than 20% of the group revenue, which put us at the very vanguard of the industry, 20%. It's a high percentage, and it will grow further. What I see in addition is even in the soft economies like Holland and France, we are growing rapidly digital services. So there's something that groups our consulting skills and technology skills, because we sell no longer to the CIO, the IT department, but to the end user. That's why we need consulting contribution, and that's growing very, very rapidly. Today, the most exciting opportunities are on digital customer, and tomorrow it will be on digital manufacturing, so it's there to last, even if next year we will find new naming for that.
Finally, what is your macroeconomic outlook, and what is your updated guidance for the rest of the year?
The first point is we have built our guidance based on a constant outlook. We do not expect a fast acceleration of Europe. We don't expect either a big slowdown in Asia caused by the Chinese recent alarms. So based on that constant outlook, we just raised our guidance on many aspects. So we raised our revenue, including IGATE, in the second half, since IGATE has been fully acquired by the group on July 1st, growth above 12% in current figures, margin 10.3, taking into account the gate contribution in the second half, and we maintain our free cash flow guidance of more than 600 million.
Paul Hermelin, CEO of Capgemini, thank you very much.
Thank you, Adrien.